Excuse me. Hey guys, Lewted host here with another dank stream. Where to begin with this stream? Basically, I wanted to continue talking about Matchlocks. I don't think I'll go into my campaign on this stream. I'll do it off stream. And yeah, basically, I'm going to continue talking about Matchlocks, and I'll show you guys a replay I got this morning. And I hope it helps out. It should. I wanted to do something, but I can't remember what I wanted to do. Probably it was just talk about the Portuguese Turcos, but I can hold that off. So right now my setup, my retainer setup, is it boosts the melee attack of cavalry, swords, and Naginata warrior monks, and warrior nuns, of course, by 2, and then I use Renew's Teachings, which takes away one of that, but gives them 3 defense. 3 defense to all of my units, including the ones that aren't affected, like Naginata Samurai, and so on. But of course, it's the reload speed that really messes you up. Anyway, I want to get into the replay before I forget about it. And this was interesting. This was against a fall of the Samurai army. I brought a offensive build. I did not bring bows, but I think you'll be entertained with what I did bring. This. Anyway, should be good. So basically, I had 4 katana samurai, 2 of which were veterans, 3 warrior monks. One of them was over here. This one had 17 attack, which I thought was pretty good. This can go up to 20 with Inspire, and then 22 with Stand and Fight. By this time, I wasn't using Renew's Teachings. I was using Relentless so that these guys could get a speed boost. I kind of did my Katana Samurai dirty though. Went to get this. Oh yeah. I brought 2 Yari Cav, Warrior Monk Cav, but I also brought these 2 units. The Dunderbuss Cav, of course I was talking about them before, Shotgun Cav, and the Portuguese Turcos. Now I was just being unorthodox with this build because of course I'm going up against the fall of the Samurai army, so you want to bring bow units most of the time. Well, I just thought to myself, you know what, I have nothing to lose, so I'm going to do it, and that's what I did. Brought it. Kind of did pay off in the end, but most of the times you don't want to use matchlocks when you're going up against the fall of the Samurai army. Matchlocks vet worse than line infantry do. Line infantry vet the same way that bow samurai do. Whoops, I fast forward too much. Over here I started to fire on his carbine cav, which came too close to my main cav. But then he had support, so I decided to pull out. But yeah, these Dunderbuss cav did pretty well initially. 28 kills. I did make some micro mistakes here. Like I was trying to bring my Warrior Monk cav up, but then I ended up using my Katana Samurai to block these Yari Ki, and that wasn't what I wanted at all. He moves up his carbine cav. He starts shooting on this unit of Katana cav again. I bring up my Dunderbuss cav to get into range of his units. And yeah, that's a pretty devastating damage to myself. Another one. takes a while for them to reload, but I got the Archery Dojo. So that's good. His bow cav was still firing on me. He has a semi hero. Didn't really help him out. Yeah, that was pretty much it for that carbine calf. Got 39 kills though, so. I don't know. Now, fast forward again, he brings down a unit of line infantry. For what reason, I don't know. But I'm doing pretty good, so I feel confident that I can attack the hill even though I have no bow units. And therefore, no unit that can actually tackle these units at a better range than he can tackle me. I might do a Modern Fall of the Samurai army build, but I want to get my avatar to level 9 first. I know this changes in Gumi Police Force is coming up, but I wanted to use my Warrior Monk Cav to deter these, the Bow Cav, but then the Yari Key that were there as well. Unfortunately, I was only able to get my Katana Samurai up, and by the time I realized the mistake, he already charged into me. But I did counter with my Warrior Monk Cav, so I did partial good. My Thunderbust Cav come back. The flanks are exposed, they're wavering, but they're not going to rout until they come to this group. His Yari can try to intercept my Thunderbust Cav. They didn't even catch them. Actually, they did. They caught them, but then they didn't really kill them. So these units did well, the Shinsengumi Police Force did well. He had a few others though. He had sharpshooters and then one right here. He brought Spear Levy for whatever reason. Just a bad setup. And this guy was Gold Prestige too, I didn't put that in the title. I bring back my Dunderbuss Cav. Most likely to deal with the units like Levy here all of a sudden. Good thing that units in Shogun 2 don't have Arthur shot, or else these tactics would not work for me, and I just get baited. So over here, my Portuguese Turcos, notice that his sharpshooters are over here. They're not firing at them, they're firing into this blob, but that's causing some friendly fire as well. And this unit of Shinsengumi Police just got massacred in that first rally. 49 men lost.
Our men are running from the battlefield. Shameful display.
Firing to the front of these Shinsengumi Police Force. His entire center routed and going to his general. The Shinsengumi Police Force did well. Yeah. One of the only times that I used matchlocks. The only time I used matchlocks, I ended up winning.
My lord, their general has fallen! A cutting blow!
Yeah, I got his general, and that was pretty much it. Just a mass rope at this point. That was so bad on his end, though. Oh yeah, that's true. It's a good quote. Not everyone knows, though. So yeah, I did post my findings into the Shogun 2 stream that I did yesterday when I uploaded it to YouTube. So I'm still doing tests like with matchlocks. You can get over I think you can get 90 reload with Portuguese Turcos. Because then you can boost it up. Yeah, you should be able to. I say that because Portuguese Turcos... Whoops. I already have them at a 45, but I'm using Renu's teachings. So they have 45. Reload would put that up to 50. Rapid Volley would bring that up to 65. Inspire would bring that up to 75. And Standard Fight would bring it up to 80. Oh, no. The most you can get, I think, for Portuguese Turcos is 85 if you have the retainer. The Western Armor Set retainer. I forgot what the retainer is called. So anyway, I got another Katana Samurai to Vet 9, so I'm happy about that. Where are you? Yeah, over here. This one did before this one, which was surprising. Because this was a level 8 when this was a level... No, this was a level 7 when this was a level 8. Pretty surprising. But anyway, it happens. I haven't used my katana here in a while. I think I'll give them a try. My ladder standing is pretty decent. It hasn't moved too much. This is my best ladder placement. It used to be like much worse. Like I'm talking about like, used to be in the 10,000s. Now I'm at 911. Pretty good. Pretty good. But it can be better. With this avatar, I haven't been using my clan tokens too much. Right now I'm using the Bushido chain to support my melee endeavors. When I level up, I'm getting Heroic Assault. Actually, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. I can't. I need another point in melee attack in order to do that. I thought I could, but alas. Anyway, let's go into Shogun 2. I'm close to getting to level 9. Surprise, surprise. Clan Long has been doing a lot of work in this province. We had this province, but then they just took it. The Miyamoto's Don's Island is very active. Like, they've been doing this all day. But it's okay, because I'm still working on this province. We'll just try to take it from them. We still have tomorrow, Saturday, and Sunday to actually win. So the biggest difference between Matchlocks and bows that you have to take into consideration when it comes to like damage per second, well, there's actually two. The damage itself, like Matchlocks do about 6 times more damage than the average bow unit. 5 times more damage than Deku Samurai, and 4 times more damage than fire arrows. But also the reload animation itself, because the reload speed, like if Matchlocks have 65 reload, and a bow samurai unit has, or yeah, a bow samurai unit, because I think the reload animation used to be different for a Shigeru. If, for example, bow samurai have 65, their reload speeds are the exact same, but the reload animation isn't. When a bow samurai unit, and I think people noticed this, but I'm going to say it anyway, when a bow samurai unit fires, they immediately reload again, and they wait for, you know, 10 or 12 seconds to shoot again. With Matchlocks, it's different. It's 12 seconds, but then there's also the animation if your unit doesn't have 90 reload, where they will put the bullet in and then start reloading. By the time they're pushing the bullet down to reload, that's when the reload skill comes into effect. And if it's at 65, it's 12 seconds until they can shoot again. And then from that time, when the bullet's actually in the lodged in the Matchlock, until the time they shoot again, that's about 2 to 3 seconds. So Matchlocks do have a longer time in general, which is why bow units with equal reload speeds tend to be able to fire just that a bit faster. But it doesn't matter too much, since Matchlocks do much more damage, and are also much more accurate overall. Per class, anyway. The only exception is when it comes to Portuguese Turcos. Because Portuguese Turcos only have 5 more accuracy than the Warrior Monks. Jifu Crossing. I don't want to use Warrior Monks this time. Sixty. Can't remember how many. I think it's the full strength. Had a brain blast. Where's my Katana Samurai that I want to? Yeah, this one. I wanted to bring a bull cab unit, but it's alright. It's alright, it's only 200 koku. It's a problem with thinking fast. Matchlocks are not recommended when you're going up against Father Samurai armies. Even if it's a traditional army, it's not something that you want to do. And I'm saying this from experience. Oh yeah, I wanted to bring ninjas, that's what I wanted to do. That's alright. Not a big deal. I want to bring ninjas instead of warrior monks. Because the last time I did bring ninjas, it worked out pretty well. I think ninjas work better in traditional Father Samurai armies because they actually are limited to no warrior monks anyway.
Thank you.
why he's doing this, but...
Our men are running from the battlefield! A shameful display!
Make sure these guys run off the battlefield.
Thank you. One of our units has used all its ammunition, my lord. My lord, a glorious victory will soon be yours.
That was kind of disappointing. I mean, I was thinking that he would try to use his units a bit better. He only had one unit of cav, and when I got that out of the way, I just had to get the rest of his units. He couldn't even support each other because, yeah, they were even near each other. Next time, though, I need to bring ninjas. My fire cav had a really easy time going through those units. Two charge, two morale, one speed. I'm going to probably upgrade the defense twice. Actually, no, I do the melee attack. I'm going to do it. I want to look at that replay though, because I didn't save it, I just realized. I didn't save it. Or I did. But I didn't put it as a heroic. Let me just look, go through that battle again, because I was on the phone. I might do this more often, go over the battles in greater detail. So I got a nice setup, obviously. Both of these are Vet 9 Pro Samurai. I can get another one, but I because I'm still exploring options. The Staker Samurai is already much better. It has 175 base range, so I can upgrade it to
20.
Somewhat useful. Who knows? So he starts the fire on my Deku Samurai. It takes up 6. benefits flying during this formation. I find loose formation benefits more from shrapnel shot. Like, for protecting themselves against shrapnel shot. Armstrong guns, like, I don't know if he stopped firing or if they ran out of ammunition. I'm going to assume they ran out of ammunition, because that sounds a bit better. So now, my katana samurai, including this either one, so it should be, all of them should have been engaging, but they weren't, mainly because of how he presented his attack. So basically, he brings up his 150 range Tosa rifle, brings up his general because it's his only gun cab unit. And the first thing he does is he uses it to go up against my Bull 7. Now this is already a bad idea because even though they have 5 armor, it's your general, you know. This is the unit that you want to protect overall. And instead, he's just using it over here. And so it allows me to get fire arrows and shoot that. Now, I don't get to fire on with my Deku Samurai. They're firing on this Tosa Rifleman up there. It doesn't even matter. I don't think they might have been. I could have been able to take out the game and use it to see the guys attack. He wants to fire at my Yari cow. That's fine, but he's not going to be able to because there's a shot record. He starts to fire on my cavalry. I put them into the forest. Yeah, over here, he gets a few shots into my base ammo. That's fine, I'm getting a lot of kills in here. There's my shots. Technically speaking, you almost never need Matchlock Samurai. They're relatively useless. They're really fucking decent though. They're Matchlock catching in this case. Matchlock Samurai are useful. But these guys have terrible stats. Like 25 accuracy is terrible. Now this unit keep coming out of nowhere. I already know I'm gonna lose by charging it anyway. Because there's a unit of Katana Samurai here. Lone Sword Shigeru. I have to pull out my Yari Kai, but I couldn't really do it without losing this one. Still do it anyway. But yeah. He loses his Yari Kai. That's fine. Lone Sword Shigeru did a great job. Yari Kachi comes up.
Our men are running from the battlefield! Shameful display!
Worked out in the end because I got rid of the cavalry. This unit of Samurai has 39 kills, 33 kills on the Deku Samurai, and 77 on this one. All thanks to the 80 reload. The Yari Kachi came back, and the Deku Samurai by my fire pack. They're pretty fast, and I think speed upgrades are like extremely useful for all cavalry, especially katana cav, because they need it. I noticed that he's using the unit of bear patrol up there. I noticed this unit of spear levy coming to my position. I didn't even have to pull these guys back, they probably would have been able to shoot them down. Over here is Yari Kachi, decides to engage with my Lone Sword of Shigeru. Not getting good way with my Lone Sword of Shigeru. Luckily, I have my Katana Samurai nearby. This unit of Bull Samurai is firing. And this unit of Spear Levy. It's funny to note though, it actually takes 4 seconds for them to reload, but because of pathfinding, it takes longer sometimes. These guys rotted because I hit them in the back. I decided to start firing on this unit of Imperial Guard infantry. Why he has it, I don't know, but yeah. Pretty bad investment considering that Shogun units are available to you as well. The upgrades, however, aren't. Still, it's better to have a Shogun unit. Unless, of course, if you're in a clan, because I don't know if it's different for clans, because I wasn't in a clan. If I was in my clan, I wasn't even in a Shogun 2 clan. At this point, I'm still trying to fire on his units. I do get this unit of Tulsa riflemen. Actually, no, I didn't. I got them later on. But yeah, the damage for bowlers went down by a lot, so they're only really useful against low armored units. Katana Kachi have a fair bit amount of armor. Gary Kachi have less, which is surprising. But it doesn't really matter too much as far as damage, since the bullets pierce armor anyway.
Units has used all its ammunition, my lord.
It's extremely easy to do it. The well, then I can do it to this unit as well. They already lost 50 men. They're gonna lose the rest of their men and carry on the fight. Let's see this unit is pretending the same one. Get in here somehow.
My lord! Yeah, a glorious victory will soon
so,
be yours!
I only use, like, I think a portion of my army. My bow samurai and Deku samurai got hit fairly often. This unit did pretty well. This unit did okay. Yeah. This unit did okay as well. These Katana Samurai didn't do anything. Warrior Monks did nothing. My General's all the way back here. My Light Cav is okay as well. So yeah, I mean, could have done a bit better. Really, I mean, sure, my Lone Sword Shigeru did really well. It could have been a lot worse. But they shouldn't have done well in the first place. They shouldn't have been able to tackle the Yari Ki. Should have had his sword support on the flanks. A lot of things went wrong for him and just ended in a heroic victory for me. And I leveled up to level 9. I'm going to try to do a Follow the Samurai build though. I'm hoping that I can get back to level 10 before what is it? Before my Christmas. I also want to do a bunch of other stuff. Now, what's funny about traditional units is that they have, with the exception of the samurai hero, they don't have any
abilities that you can get at level 9. Like, this isn't an ability, this is a skill. But you can get it at level 9, and you have to be part of a bow specialism clan, which makes no sense because there are people that play Fall of the Samurai only, but don't have Shogun 2. I don't think they took that into consideration. But anyway, the bow hero is useless. The unit size isn't good enough. Swooping Crane isn't good enough either. It does make it harder to hit the unit, but it's not an ability I use anyway. I'm gonna try to use a modern build. I haven't been doing it for a while, ever since that carbine, or the last one I did, I think last week. Just give me 1 second, guys. I think the funniest thing about Fall of the Samurai is that one of the funniest things is that all of the units level up the same. Samurai Hero, all of them, because Fall of the Samurai is considered a DLC. And DLC units already have that standard scaling factor as well. It is harder to level up as you gain put skill points into experience, but yeah. I thought it was a level 10, level 8 with this count. I guess I was a level 9 and I didn't even notice. First things first. I didn't change my retainers. Say hello. Second thing. What do I want? Definitely. Famous armory. Not really. I'm not going to use bow cav. Spoiled rations, always. Gorge. Could make a good center. Might have to get rid of these units though. That's 8 units of infantry. Line infantry, that is. Wanted to bring a unit of carbine cav. Do I have one that isn't? Yeah. Two reload, one accuracy. Surprisingly, accuracy doesn't work the same way as it does in Shogun, the base game. The choice 7. Hidden Gorge isn't like a map that you'd really want to be too aggressive on. Blade Master can help in this situation. We have to change these units. Something I don't really want to do. That could work. I mean, I'm trying to get this unit up. And this unit already has good stats. Well, let's give it a try. He's split between leader and sword trees. So chances are he has no penalty against spears. He either has that or scares enemies or both. I mean, increased morale is also important, but it's either that or a full melee, a full swordsman tree. I've already done the full swordsman tree. It's good. You know, it works. But it's also very problematic if you don't risk your general. And it also encourages you to risk your general, which also isn't good. I think it should allow the general to be more able to lead from the front instead of having to be at the back. Of course, I'm a Bushido general, so this is going to be very interesting. Now, apparently, this retainer does not work against Fallen Samurai Army, so actually, it does work against Matchlock Catchy since they wield the Matchlock anyway. But in general, it doesn't work besides that. Blade Master works. I'm relying on it, though. It's a hard map to play on.
Yes, sir. Sir, United States Marines, sir.
I can definitely see it working. First things first, all units on guard, except this container. Farmhouse, I won't need. Alright. Shrine is important, but I won't need it for the most part. Realistically speaking, he's going to need the farmhouse more than I do in this. Well, no, he doesn't actually. He just has to keep his units near him, or else they'll tire out. That includes his cavalry. I don't have to do that because my melee cavalry already have a bonus to fatigue since I'm a Bushido master. I want to get this this archery dojo. Allows me to have better reloading. Definitely will work out for these red bears who need it more than anything. Surprised I haven't gotten these guys to level 7. The Tulsa Hunters were my first veteran unit. After that, I didn't think I want to focus on what is it? I wouldn't want to focus on anything else. So he brought Matchlock, Ashigaru, Bow Warrior Monks. Bow Warrior Monks are good, but you got one. No, you did bring two. Bow Samurai, Tanis Samurai, Naginata Samurai on the flanks, that's good. Use my cavalry to capture points. I just remembered I can use them to capture this point faster. I don't have to dismount. I might have to dismount these carbine cavalry. Yeah, it looks like I will. I guess it works only for melee generals. These guys are winded.
Has hidden units, sir. Shogun's general, an ambush! A unit is running from the battlefield, sir. A unit is running from the battlefield, sir. Unit is running from the battlefield, sir. Sir, your general is under attack. Triumphed over the enemy.
So it kind of worked out, I guess. honestly thought I was at level 8. Cost 851. Was that a costly or a close? I think that was costly. I'll have to go look at it again. Yeah, I did better than I expected, though. He probably underestimated these guys' power in melee. Like, these guys don't do that well. These guys, on the other hand, do fairly well. Plus 2 attack and defense goes a long way. Like, these guys can beat warrior monks in combat. They just suffer on the charge. These guys did good, surprisingly. These guys did alright. Survived long enough. The black bears didn't really do that well. But these guys did fairly well. I haven't upgraded this unit yet because I don't know what to put it in. Suppressive fire is good. I'd rather get 2 reload and then get melee attack, but I'm not sure yet what I want to do. I have to be part of an Imperial clan though to get increased range. Doesn't matter to me what I do. But you know what? I'm going to end the stream here because I'm probably just going to jump into Rome 2. I don't want to bore you guys anymore, so thanks guys so much for watching. I'd even check my Twitch chat. Nobody said anything anyway. Doesn't matter. But yeah. To summarize about the Matchlocks, I'm still getting into it, but Matchlocks do suffer from that reload animation since bow units don't have it. They do more damage though, so it doesn't really matter. The only units that can get tackled a lot better by Matchlocks is Naginata Samurai. And basically units with a good amount of armor, like this other Samurai. The only exceptions are Bow and Matchlock Samurai, obviously. They have 4 armor. It's decent, but 5 armor is better. So anyway, guys, thanks so much for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Bye, guys.